right, so we're going to play a little game. It's called Keep It or Ditch It, because there's a lot of different things going on in the bubble. And we talked last week about NBA changes that could possibly stay for good. So let's go through some of these and say whether we would like to keep it or ditch it. Omar, you are in the bubble. You get to see firsthand coaches wearing polos instead of suits. It's a little bit more casual down there. Would you keep that or would you ditch that?
So you guys are gonna hate this answer, but I hate it because I can't figure out where the coach is sitting. And I'm always trying to keep my eye on the coach because I want to see what they're yelling. If you kind of put your ear closer to that area, you can see what Doc Rivers is yelling. So the problem is with the spaced out benches and all the coaches wearing the same clothes, it's hard to figure out where everyone's sitting. I had a hard time seeing where Quinn Snyder was for the Jazz for a little bit. So I personally don't like it for that reason.
You don't think you can't see what the coaches are yelling because some of them are wearing masks, maybe? That could be part of it?
No. I also do want to say, as someone that is always wearing a bomber jacket, I like when the coaches are wearing blazers as well.
And then they get to show off their style just a tad bit. You know, you get to see how fresh they are because they have a little diversity on the bench, maybe. I don't know.
I'm ditching this one always. Like, the polo looks a little bit too much like a substitute teacher. Like, it feels like not your normal teacher. It's just a person that came in for the day that doesn't really know anything about biology. It's just getting you through it. That, like, Luke Walton definitely looked like that there. So I'm out on this.
Like, I actually agree with that one.
If they're going to wear polos, make it like quarterbacks in the NFL in practice. Make them wear, like, red so you can see it from a mile away. You're like, there we go. That solves everybody's problem.
So the head coach has to wear a bright shirt. All right, Omar, you talked about the benches. Are you keeping or ditching the bigger benches? Do you like that or no?
I am ditching the bigger benches as well because you miss out on moments. If you guys remember, Larry Nance Jr. had to give up his seat to Kobe Bryant and had to sit on the floor because there was no seats available. Same thing last year with Mo Wagner. LeBron's going to the bench. There's no seat for him. He tells the rookie Mo Wagner, sit down on the floor. So you're going to miss out on those moments because everything is too perfect in this bubble. We need to have those moments for some laughter.
Makes sense.
Okay, can I modify it? Okay. I mean, I don't want to ditch it all the way.
Okay.
I just want them to be like big lazy boys and somebody to come up with like popcorn and a drink. Like when he puts his feet up, I want him greeted with a snack and a smile. Like, I just think that would be, I'd be interested. Like, is he a Junior Mints guy or a Mike and Ike's guy? Like, I want to know where it's going.
That'd be very interesting. I don't know if people would be ready to play in games if they were sitting in lazy boys, but that would be interesting.
Maybe the guys
that are injured, that are just basically watching a movie, they can just lean back. I will say though, however, it's not as fun because you know how players get hype when something big happens and they're like, yeah, with their teammates. They can't do that. Their teammates, like, all the way over there, they got to be like, hey, did you just see what happened? It's a little not as personable. All right, so next, there are no cameras or photographers on the baseline, which is a good thing because now people aren't in danger. Do you like that or do you not like that?
So I like it. I would keep this. The only thing that I think has been interesting watching a few times is, as silly as it sounds, the wider baselines have created instances where I feel like players don't realize how close to the edge they are. Like, they're so used to seeing people. You're finding guys step out accidentally on the baseline a little bit more than we're used to.
Yeah.
It's like a weird spacing issue even for the players. Once they get used to it, though, I think it's a much safer and actually much cleaner look. And it seems like they go a little bit more fearlessly to the basket. So I'm all in for it. I'd keep it.
So once they get used to it, then maybe it's a little bit better. Omar, what do you think?
I like it. I do wish they had some, like, cell phone videographers sitting underneath the basket, and I would volunteer as tribute as someone that has posted a lot of those clips. I would know all the ins and outs.
I was going to say, only a social media guy that literally lives on phone video would say something like that. If they did cell phone video rather than having a huge camera, that would work for me.
I'm being serious. People love the cell phone video because it's raw, and everyone's so familiar with it. I think. Yes, exactly.
Exactly. All right. What doesn't feel real? Digital fans. Are we keeping that or ditching that?
I'm keeping it. Look, as a combo, I want the regular fans in the building. But there has been something to me that's really cool in the concept of having a massive digital wall. Like, if you're somebody that doesn't live anywhere near your favorite team, but you can have yourself represented on a digital wall in a way where you can feel like you're part of the game and be part of the experience, I think it's a cool way to get non-local fans non-regional fans invested in their team in an interesting way. So I don't want it to replace fans. I want fans back in the building. But I think it'd be awesome if they built some sort of a wall that allowed fans to still be a part of it this way.
Moms can be on the digital board like we just saw. Omar, what do you think? You get to see it live. What do you think about it?
So I completely agree that it's a cool gesture for those fans. And also when you have like Paul Pierce and those reactions, that's great as well. But I feel like it kind of ruins the experience. I'm not big on the virtual fans. It's kind of weird. And I hate when there's a cool dunk, like a LeBron James dunk, and there's weird virtual fans in the background. It just looks wrong in my opinion. But if they want to do those celebrity virtual fans, that's cool with me because those reactions are always kind of hilarious.
So to recap, Omar wants to be able to be under the basket to take a cell phone video, but you don't want other people on their cell phone to be on a wall in the arena at the same time.
Yes.
Come on, man.
Yes.
Hypocrisy at its finest.
I'm a selfish human being, unfortunately, and I would like to apologize for that.
I respect the heck out of appreciating your hustle. Like, go for the opportunity. If you can get it, get it.
Do you? I think it's very interesting because digital fans, it's been fun to watch some of them, but some of them look like they're so uninterested in what's actually going on. I get that they're in their home, so they're just like watching a basketball game, chilling on their couch. But then like Paul Pierce just like chilling, like what is even happening? It's like, hey, there's people can see you.
I'll take the opposite side on that though, you know, because I think part of the reason I love the digital fans is I moved around a lot as a kid, so I was never around my favorite team. When I watch my favorite teams play, it's not family friendly and it is not safe for people to observe. I am really surprised we haven't seen somebody just lose their mind on one of those things when they don't. I mean, we've seen the Cobra, like, that's cool, that's fine.
Yeah.
But I'm surprised we haven't seen one of those moments like that go viral of somebody chucking something or you know, obviously reading their lips and realizing that they did not say something that their moms would approve of. I'm just saying.
That's just them editing that part out. They're like, don't show that fan right now because that is not family appropriate, like you said. All right, last one. Are we keeping or ditching the camera angle? Some people say it looks a little bit too much like NBA 2K, but I kind of like that. I mean, make it look like a video game.
I'm all in on that. And look, again, I'll make the parallel to some of the other sports. When you think about baseball and the NFL, part of what they did after video games blew up in those respective cultures is they started to mirror the broadcast to those video games. I mean, you've seen the graphics change tremendously in the way these packages are presented to look more video game-like. So give me any of these. And look, I think everybody resists these camera angles at first because it's not what you're used to. But anytime you can really see the cuts and the angles and where guys are going for them and get you a better idea of who's open, I think that's really cool and it's a great angle. What do you think, Omar?
I actually agree. The one thing that we agree on is that all the different angles have been a lot of fun to see. They've been experimenting, which has been nice. And my favorite one is the robot cam. Is that what it's called? The robot cam that keeps
Robo
sliding
cam?
By itself robotically?
Yeah.
Robo cam. But, you know, to credit to the NBA, there's not that many like media folks here that are trained to be with cameras. There's maybe three or four cameramen / women. And they've done an amazing job of experimenting and doing all this, using all this technology to get all these cool angles. So major, major credit to the NBA for pulling this off.
And I think another thing about making it look like NBA 2K, like you were saying, kids like playing video games. Maybe they'll like watching basketball a little bit more if it looks like the video games that they're playing.
And look, I think that's great. And you're right. I mean, and once we get used to it, I think everybody's going to fall in love with it. People always resist these changes. Omar made a great point, too. Experimentation in the bubble is key. That's part of the opportunity you get. So if the NBA can take some of these things and keep them, I think it's a huge win for the league.
I made myself sound like an old person. Kids like playing. I like video games, too. I'm not that old.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.